program confirmed.
Go and throttle up.
You are now listening
to the Dirtbag Block of Rock.
Thank you for taking the time out to spend some time with us this afternoon. Got to thank Dirtbag as well for setting all this love and understanding up.
Oh, absolutely. I love Dirtbag. I was in a band for 6 years called Black Hair.
Right.
We were from Eugene, Oregon. And Dirtbag was our first endorsement. And so, you know, I'm real familiar with Dirtbag. So I figured. I got to hit them up for my solo stuff, you know. So
absolutely, yep. Man.
Well, this is Zach. I have not been doing too much.
Right on. Well, you got cocky on your solo stuff and you decided to do a story, like a thematic album, which is...
Right, exactly. It's the first time I ever did it. And, you know, I've been writing music for like 11 years now. And I just figured it was time to just like really challenge myself, you know?
Very cool.
So I'm like, you know what? I'm going to try it, you know?
Very cool.
And it's kind of scary because, you know, it's just, I don't know, concept albums, it's kind of a scary thing, you know? It could either be great or corny, you know? So
that is a stone cold fact, right?
Yeah.
We won't mention that one group who did one and it stank on ice back in the 80s, but we'll just let that one go.
Right.
So you decided to do the concept album. You're like doing this crazy thing with you and your buddy, just doing the whole stinking album. And when you two were thinking about this, were you thinking of throwing the massive amount of time into deciding to do different styles in this thing? Because at the beginning to the end, it's a different animal, man.
Right, exactly. And that's just kind of what I like to do. I don't like to put myself kind of, you know, in a genre. I like to do, you know, whatever the hell I want, really, you know? So that's just kind of the way I am. Since I started doing my solo stuff, actually, I have three albums out, two that I've had Jacob do the instrumentals and mix and master. I always just like, you know, doing different genres and really pushing myself, seeing what I can do, you know.
Okay. What genre do you feel most comfortable in, or are you good with just spreading it?
I'm good with just spreading it mostly, but, you know, metal has been, you know, like my main genre for like 11 years.
Excellent. So when you're putting this thing together, where did you go to master this thing?
My friend Jacob, who did all the instrumentals, he mixed and mastered it for me. He's actually all the way in Rhode Island.
Oh man. And okay.
And we send each other the files and that's how we've done it for two albums now.
All right.
So I actually found him off of YouTube.
No kidding.
And when I was doing my first album, I was looking up royalty-free metal instrumentals that I could buy from someone, and his popped up. And so I had to make me two custom instrumentals for my first kind of solo, I guess you could call it solo project.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, I just decided to use him full time because he's just amazing.
Well, the production sounds amazing. Let's talk some gear, man, because what you got going on with your tone and the way you've split it up genre-wise, are you using the same rigs, or how did you split that up?
Well, I use the same microphone through the whole thing. It's just an AKG Perception 200.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually just got it a few years ago just from my mom's friend. Her son had it and he wasn't using it. It was just sitting in the garage.
No,
so she just gave me this microphone.
All right.
And so, man, I've used it so much, you know, I love the thing.
Sounds really good. What are you using for guitar gear?
I'm not quite sure. Jacob is the guy who does all that.
Are you doing most of the vocals? Are you doing most of the guitar work? What did you do most on this album?
I do all the vocals and he does all the instrumentals.
Okay.
And, I write the lyrics, come up with the vocal melody, Yeah, that's what I do.
So when you're putting it together, are you just relying on his good fortune and instincts to throw some of these guitars together, or what are you thinking?
Well, yeah, absolutely. You know, I mean, I trust the guy 100%. I have not heard one instrumental of his that I don't like. And I mean, he makes hundreds of instrumentals a year, and I still haven't heard one that I couldn't get behind.
Very cool.
But I kind of tell him a direction that I want to go, you know?
Okay.
For example, I'll be like, you know, I want to be inspired by Alice in Chains on this song, or we got a song called Tear Them Down. Mm-hmm. He sent me this thing where it's, he did an orchestra song, and I'm like, man, that would be so cool if we could mix metal in that and do a song with an orchestra metal song. And so that's what a Tear Them Down became.
Very cool. Now you got some heavy stuff on here too, man. You got A Glimpse, you got Words, The Beast, Just Another Broken Dream. I mean, that half of this album is just munchy, brother. It is heavy.
Yeah, that's actually the second half is my favorite half, because that's the stuff that I did towards the end. Due to the fact this was a concept album,
okay,
I had to record each song in the exact order,
right,
to get the story. So the stuff I tend to like is the stuff more towards the end.
Very cool. Very cool. Did it take you a while to put this thing together, or were you chewing on this idea for a while?
Well, no, I thought about doing a concept album for a while, a few months.
Okay.
And then we started, I just decided to go for it, and we started recording it, and we only recorded it for probably 7 or 9 months.
Dang, look at you.
Yeah, it's crazy, you know. My album before this, we actually dropped in March of 2020.
Uh-huh.
And then this one dropped in January 1st.
Crazy.
So, yeah, I mean, during quarantine, I've just been so bored. It's just like song after song. And I'm doing a few different projects now.
Okay.
I got a project called Lost Pilot I'm doing with my good friend Cody, who I've known forever. And it's just kind of a fun little thing, you know, and it's another thing where we're doing all kinds of genres, and he does like some rapping on it. And
okay.
It's just kind of new genres I've never done before.
How comfortable do you feel in that?
You know, it's something new for me, but, you know, I love the challenge of it. So
very cool. Keep that strength growing, brother. If it ain't hurting you, then you know something wrong.
Yeah, absolutely.
Come on now.
Yeah, 100%, man.
Very cool. Well, tell everybody where they can find your stuff online, where they can purchase.
Yeah, well, I'm all over the internet, anywhere you can think of, really. Spotify, iTunes, Apple Music, Pandora, you name it. I'm on Facebook, YouTube.
And what specifically are they going to look for to find you?
They look up Zachy Sickness, and you can find all my 3 albums on there.
Very cool. And do you have a website or anything like that?
I don't have a website at the moment, so I'm just using, you know, like my social media platforms.
Very cool. So they can pick you up on like the Facebook and Instagram and what have you?
Yeah. Yep.
Right on. Well, people, you got to go jumping all over Zachy Sickness and go grab some of his grease, because he will impress the living shit out of you.
Thanks, man. I really appreciate that.
Not a problem. Do you have one single for the Block of Rock?
Yeah.
Which one are you going to go for?
I think it, man. It's a tough choice because I love them all, but I'll probably go with Tear Them Down.
Very cool.
Because that's my instrumentalist favorite song, and he's really proud of the production, and I'm proud of how that song came out, too. I just think it's really different.
Very cool. Very cool. Can't wait to have it on the Block of Rock and impress the living crap out of everybody. It's going to be fantastic.
Hell yeah.
I appreciate everything that you're doing out there. I want to thank again, Dirtbag, for putting this all together, and I want to thank you, too, man, because this is, like I said, it's It's not often when some crazy yokel says, you know what, I'm bored and I'm going to put a concept album together. And one that actually works. So congratulations.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
You're very welcome, brother.
This is Zach from Zachy Sickness. You are listening to Tear Them Down right here on the Dirtbag Block of Rock.
Music from Zachy Sickness and other dirtbag artists, visit dirtbag.com. Subscribe to our YouTube channel at Dirtbag Clothing 1996. The Block of Rock is brought to you by Dirtbag Clothing, sponsored by EMG Pickups.